Mercury or quicksilver. What an amazing element it is. It's a metal, but it's a liquid. And believe it or not, it was first discovered about 2000 BC by the ancient Chinese, as well as by the ancient Hindus. They found that heating a mineral, which we now call cinnabar, it's mercuric sulfide, would release mercury. We understand why. Because oxygen in the air combines with the sulfur, strips it away from mercury, forms sulfur dioxide, and leaves metallic mercury behind. The alchemists were absolutely taken with this because they thought that this was the base of all metals, that every substance that seemed to be metallic was a combination of mercury with something else. They thought that gold was a combination of mercury and sulfur. So they tried mixing sulfur with mercury. They tried mixing lead with sulfur to see whether or not when that was mixed with mercury, they would come up with gold. They tried all these things. Well, lead is still lead, and the alchemists are now dead. They never found the secret to making gold. But there are other secrets that lie within mercury. In the 11th century, an alchemist by the name of Jabir ibn Haya, somewhere in the Arabian Peninsula, discovered that if you heated mercury with salt, you would get a white crystalline material. It came to be called corrosive sublimate. Today we know it is mercuric chloride. Well, mercuric chloride is not only toxic, but it's very corrosive. Corrosive sublimate is the old name for it. Well, it does have a medical use, because if you have some kind of disfiguration on the skin, whether it is a mole or some disease process such as some disfiguration secondary to syphilis, if you put mercuric chloride on there, it does alleviate the condition. It can also make the skin whiter. Of course, at the same time, it is poisoning you. Paracelsus, the famed alchemist and physician, recommended mercury chloride as a treatment for syphilis. It did have some effect on the disfiguring bumps and bruises that characterize syphilis, but of course it did not cure the disease. Today, chloride, unfortunately, still sometimes crops up in skin whitening solutions and ointments. These are illegal in Canada and in the US, but they are sometimes imported, mostly from the Caribbean or from Africa, where even soaps are manufactured with mercuric chloride. This is a very dangerous thing to do because mercury is highly toxic. And even the metal itself gives off vapors that are toxic. And as you can see, I have this sealed very, very well so that I'm not inhaling any of the vapors. However, I must say that when I was young, we played with mercury. When a thermometer broke, we would play around with it in our hands. Luckily, that was before it was toxic.